that damn sound. Yeah, my name ring bells. Yeah, my name ring bells. Yeah, my name ring bells. What you doing? Getting money, switching cars and chickens like it's nothing. Blowing haze in the air. Yeah, I'm always in the sun. You hear that damn sound. Yeah, my name ring bells. Yeah, my name ring bells. Yeah, my name ring bells. What you doing? Getting money, switching cars and chickens like it's nothing. Blowing haze in the air. Yeah, I'm always in the sun. The next topic we're going to discuss on Boxing Bros are what are the chances that Juan Montiel upsets Jermall Charlo. I'm going to turn it over to Ned the TBE, our lead predictor.
He steals predictions and pay-per-view.
And points of views.
The chances of Juan Montiel upsetting Jermall are zero. I give him no chance against Jermall. I think it's going to be an easy pick. It's going to be an easy fight for my mans. And, you know, he's going to tune up, tune the skills, do what he has to do, and knock him out. Simple. There's nothing more to say. No more, G, you're going to steal it. Trills, you're going to steal it. Kaden, you might even steal it too. But, hey, there you go. It's my time to brag. I went first.
Thanks, Ned.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ned.
Blessings.
Yeah, man, I give Juan 10% chance. And here's why. Man, Charlo is not a Kirk Franklin. You know what I mean? Not Kirk Franklin.
You going to stop.
James Kirkland, is that who you think about?
That's all I'm saying.
He's not a Kirk Franklin.
He gonna take him to church. He gonna bless him. He gonna bless Juan next time.
Views and opinions of G. How dare you say Kirk Franklin? I don't want smoke where.
But Juan, he's just too slow. Like Charlo's way faster than him, and not to mention, his style, the Juan Montiel, whatever. Man, it's like sloppy, bro. Like, I don't know. He's going to move forward. He's going to get hit. He's going to move forward again. He's going to keep getting hit, you know. And I don't know if he can hold up to those type of punches that y'all are going to be delivering. So, that's why I have it at a 10% chance, man. So, yeah.
All right. Dollar Bill.
The chances. I believe that Juan Montiel, he has comes from a fighting family. Shout out to his cousin. What is it? Fernando Montiel. The two-time bantamweight champion, right? Was a huge fan of his cousin. That was his cousin. He comes from a fighting family. And his grandfather was actually champion as well. Come from a fighting family. I'm giving him a puncher's chance. The kid can fight. The kid can fight. I don't think it's going to be one of those we're going in there to watch a wash, but I do think that we're going to probably get a stoppage, but I think it's going to be a hard-fought stoppage. You know? There's a reason why that they're doing this all access on this fight, you know? Juan Montiel, he's not like a... Like, I don't give him credit for the Kirkland fight. I don't give him credit because
I don't think anyone does.
I don't think nobody does.
Ned does.
But he's been laying paws on other people as well. You know, that other up and coming fighters before here that was supposed to be in line, he's been laying paws on them. It was only one notable win of somebody that people actually know their names because he fought Canelo was Kirkland. But,
James Kirkland.
We got two players. I'm sorry. Are you with me? He messing me up. But yeah. There's a reason why they're doing the one on this fight because this kid Montiel can punch, and if Jermall goes in there, and he's not 100% focused. We done seen it all the time in boxing. He has to be focused for this fight. He can't let this kid hit him. Because this kid can punch. He really can punch. Far away from, take away the James Kirkland, this kid can punch other than that, other fights. Go watch his highlights. Even though it's probably, you know, Jamal a different type of dog, this is still a tough fight, and Montiel is still a tough competitor, and he is coming to win for real. He is coming to win for real. He's been in camp for this fight. You see what I'm saying? Jamal is just getting in camp. He's been in camp already for this fight, away from his family 3 months already. So he's prepared. So I'm giving him a puncher's chance again. Well, I gave the last 120, but you know, to say the fair one plus his urge to win. So I'm going to steal from Caden. I'm going to say 30%. I'm giving him a 30% chance. One out of 10, that's a 3. So yeah, I'm going to give him a 3 chance to beat Jamal.
All right. Sounds good. Skill wise, I think there's no debating that Jamal Charlo's more talented. I think that he is a good puncher, as Trill pointed out. Hasn't been in there with anyone the caliber of Charlo, though.
No.
But still, power's power. You can show that against lower competition, against lesser competition. As you probably saw last night, someone was in there with lesser competition, but still didn't have the power to knock them out. So you can show that you have the power to get rid of lower tier opponents, and that's a testament to one having power. So he does have power. When all is said and done, I still think there's more that Charlo has to do for him to win than what he can do to win. I think Charlo has to take him lightly. Charlo has to not be 100%. Charlo has to make a mistake in order for him to win. So for that reason, I give him a puncher's chance, and I give him 20% chance to win. Although, I do like what I'm hearing. I think he's going to come to fight, but I think even him at his best, he needs a mistake from Charlo in order to win. In order to win the fight, so I'm gonna go 20%.
Yeah. Please let us know how you feel in the comment section, and check us out on Instagram and Twitter. And make sure you check out our podcast on all major streaming services. And I have to remind you that Trail Talk is coming out on June 20th. That is Father's Day on all streaming platforms. So make sure you check that out. You know who we are. We the Boxing Bros.
You're welcome. You're all welcome.